Hi, I'm Sophie, and welcome to my world. Today, we're going to become explorers. That's right, ice adventure explorers. We are going to explore the frozen tundra and find really cool toys inside. I'm going to show you how to make your own ice excavation site right now. For this, you will need fun little toys in various colors. Beads, widgets, all kinds of tiny little things that you can stick into the water. You need a deli container, measuring cups, baking soda and salt, big paintbrush, shallow bin, bucket of warm water, eyedroppers, and of course, a freezer. I'm going to use my little measuring cup. This has 5 ounces, and I'm just going to take 5 ounces of water and get that nice and set and ready. And I'm going to start with red, and I'm going to put a whole bunch of little red objects in here. Now, I don't have a red elephant, but I'm going to put a pink one in. And I do have a red lion there. And let's see, we've got some pink jewels here. And a little ring. There we go. So then I'm just going to take my water, and I'm going to pour it over top. Some things will float, some things will sink. It's okay. Don't worry about that. Now what I do is I place this into the freezer. And you're going to need to let it freeze for at least 8 hours. When it's ready, bring it out, and it should look something like this. What you're going to then do is take another 5 ounce cup of water, get that all ready, and get your next layer ready. So it goes red, orange. So let's put in a couple orange critters. A little orange brain, an orange jewel. How about a coin and an orange bracelet? And once again, pour the water over. Now, what you want to do is do this as quickly as possible and get it right into the freezer, because what you don't want to have happen is the water open up the ice below it. So you want to just get that in and get that really quickly into the freezer. And we're ready for yellow. Let's finish up with purple. Got a kind of a magenta-y there. Got a purple ring. Let's put in a couple beads. Let's put a button in, even though it's a yellow button. And a purple jewel. We're going to top it off. And finish it off with your water and place that in the freezer. Now, I've got 2 versions here. One is a smaller version, one is a larger version. I'm going to actually use the smaller version just so you can see easily. To pop it out of here, we're going to be using warm water. I've got a bucket of warm water here, and I'm just going to pop this in, the whole thing, submerge it for literally 10 seconds is all it needs. And now we get to let the excavation begin. Now, for the excavation, you're going to want things like baking soda, warm water, hot water, warm water. You don't want to be too hot with children, though. Salt, and you can even make salt water. So take some salt, add some warm water to it. Stir it up really good. And you can do the same thing with the baking soda. Make baking soda water. Put your baking soda in. Put some water in. Stir it up real good. It's great if you have paintbrushes. Paintbrushes are awesome for excavation. Now, as you can see, the ones that are on the top, the things that are on the top, float away easily and nicely. But now you want to try to start using different techniques of excavating. And I mean, you can talk about all the different, you know, explorers who went into places, you know, that were frozen, the frozen tundras, and how they had to excavate and how much time it took and how slow and careful you have to be. So I'm using warm water here. You can see it starts to melt it just a little bit. And of course, if you're doing this outside on a hot day, it's also fun. Oh, and as I'm doing this, look, you can see that the lion's foot is starting to appear. Now I'm gonna try something else. I'm gonna try some salt on my ice. I'm gonna try a little salt. So I'm just gonna shake the salt on here, and if you have rock salt, try rock salt. And I'm gonna start to give that a little brush with the brush here. And what's happening? You can see more of the lion's leg. What's happening around the coin? Starting to loosen it up and release it. You can even start trying things with your eyedropper. Try using the baking soda water. Try using the salt water. And always have that brush handy. The other thing that's great about this is as you add these different elements like salt and baking soda, you can feel the texture change. What happens? Your salt leaves these kind of groovy marks in here. It makes it kind of like sandpaper. Try some baking soda directly on here. Just take a little bit in your fingers and put it right on. And then use your brush. What happens? As you can see, this is something that takes time and patience, but it's well worth it because it's like real excavation. And you can even just see if pouring hot water onto it, what happens if you just pour hot water on? And there you have it, your own ice excavation site. Now, I do want to thank Fun at Home with Kids. Fun at Home with Kids, because they were the ones who came up with this whole idea of doing the rainbow layers in the ice. And I think it's a great one. So make sure you check out Fun at Home with Kids. Now, if you enjoyed this, give us a thumbs up and make sure you leave us a comment down below if you've tried this ice excavation or if you have any tips for what you think melts the ice the easiest other than heat. For more great ideas, check us out at sophie-world.com.